Hello, welcome. My name is Odetola Ebenyiza Israel, and I want to personally welcome you to the class. And in today's class, I'll be teaching you and also exploring with you how technology can be integrated into the classroom. I'd like you to stay tuned. Make sure you watch this video again and again. I'm going to make it as short as possible and as impactful as possible. You know, impact is the major thing, and you should at least learn one or two things at the end of this class. So let's go to the scoreboard as we start exploration right away. So this is my slide, and as I said at the beginning of the class that I'm going to be exploring technology with us. So integrating technology is the topic, and as I said, my name is Odetola Ebenyiza. I'm the founder of CME. CME is a free university of learning, and it's also called the Creative Mind Educo, and I'm an artist. I'm a learning environment therapist. I'm the founder of the platform called CME, and I'm also a teacher of children, and also a teacher of teachers. So definitely very sure you want to know more about me, like I know you know something about me. You usually get some of those information online. So what does technology integration mean? I would like you to answer this question to yourself. What does integration to technology really mean? Because so many people actually use technology. Most of us are even born with, most of us are not born with technology, but these children that we are teaching are born with technology. They are digital native. Why we are just like, a kind of a digital immigrant. We immigrated into the digital literacy space. So what does technology integration mean? I'm going to be talking about how technology can be integrated, and then what it means, and everything about this I'm going to be exploring with you today. So my introduction is what does integration to technology really mean? Technology integration is the well-coordinated use of digital devices and cloud computing as tools for problem solving and deep learning and understanding. So technology integration is what is for providing problem solving and deep learning and understanding. We all know that these students learn a lot in the classroom, and technology will actually come to stay. We enable these students to learn more and better. So that is why we are making sure that technology is part of what we do. You know, when I was introducing myself, I said I am an artist. So you will like be imagining, how can an artist be talking about technology? This is the spirit of technology. Technology is not actually leaving anybody behind. Regardless of who you are, regardless of your position, you need technology. Technology facilitates access to the curriculum, but it is not curriculum itself. Technology is not curriculum. It only facilitates the access to curriculum for the students. Teachers guide their students in using technology as a tool for assessing and understanding educational content. What technology integration actually means is that it is not the curriculum itself. It only facilitates the learning in such a way that our student can understand the content in a clear way, and it makes subjects well understood to them. So understanding technology is why we are here today, and I'm very sure that you will gain a lot at the end of this video, as I said. So understanding technology, as I said, is what making sure that you make use of technology to deliver your educational content. So it is not curriculum. It is not the major subject itself. And then it cannot replace you as the teacher. It is only going to aid your teaching in the classroom. So the success behind technology integration in education. So what are the two? I'm going to be talking about these two areas. The two success behind technology integration in Nigeria. So the first one, not in Nigeria alone, all over the world. So the first one is keeping students at the center of instruction, not technology. So one of the way to successfully blend technology into learning is to make sure that the technology, the instruction is delivered through the technology. That's why I said should, the first thing is keeping the student at the center of instruction. So the next one is understanding the role of technology. If you don't understand the role of technology, you cannot use the technology in the classroom. And then if you don't understand the role of technology, you will be thinking also that technology itself is an instruction. Technology is not an instruction. It is the driver of instruction. So regardless of who you are, you can use technology. So the next thing I'm going to talk about is authentic and meaningful technology integration is the relationship between the teacher and the student and the curriculum. I want everybody to get it clear. It is very simple that when we talk about the understanding of technology in the classroom, it actually talks about more and wider content, because so many people think technology, when we talk about technology, we are coming to actually bring the major content into the classroom. No, we are not bringing the major content into the classroom. Authentic and meaningful technology integration talks about the relationship of the what of the teacher and the student, and then the relationship of the teacher, student, and the curriculum. So what am I talking about? When you authentically use technology in a meaningful way, you are actually what? Integrating technology with what? With you as the teacher. You are integrating the technology into the student content, and you are delivering what is in your curriculum through the use of technology. Technology is the vehicle that makes it happen. Technology can make a lot happen. Technology can only make what I'm actually talking about happen. That means that building a strong relationship with students, and then building a strong relationship with the curriculum. We have been delivering the curriculum in a very fine way through the traditional method of teaching. It has been fine. It has been awesome. But I won't lie to you, when we bring technology, when we bring artificial intelligence into the classroom, children learn better. Remember, everything about them is technology. They can't do without phone. They can't do without so many things. So imagine taking a phone away from a child. The child will feel reckless. The child will feel, they can't even get sick. So technology, because they like to use this device, this 21st century tools, which is technology, we can also use this technology to also get their interest towards the learning in the classroom. Classroom technology integration begins with the teacher. Yes, nobody can actually take it away from you. Technology integration begins with you. Teachers are the determinant factor in successful technology integration. Yet it is not anybody at all. The teacher, it is not the administrator, it is not the school owner. The major person that is saying that is the major determinant of the successful integration of technology into the curriculum in the classroom is who? It is the teacher. For technology integration to be seamless, that it is inclusive, is almost automatic. Teachers must be competent in the use of it. Competency is one of the major core subjects for now. Teachers must be competent in the use of ability to use technology in the classroom. It is not easy to use technology very well in the classroom, but if you are competent in the use of technology in the classroom, you are going to find it very, very easy to actually integrate technology into the classroom. So the first thing I'm going to talk about today is how to integrate successfully the first aspect, successful way of integrating technology into the classroom, or let me just use the word understanding the devices. This aspect can be divided into various parts. So the first one, understanding how to maintain your hardware, and the second one, understanding how to maintain your software. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is the hardware maintenance. What exactly is hardware maintenance? So when we talk about hardware maintenance, we are talking about downloading and installing software. How do you know how to download and install software? I've actually downloaded a lot of software out there just by watching tutorial on YouTube. You also can do. There are some software that are not free. And then there are some software that, so far, they are not even free. You can get it for free. How do you install them? How do you get them? Where do you get them? I'll tell you, YouTube is the only place to get them. So try as much as possible. If you don't understand how to install a software, if you get a CD and you want to install that Microsoft software, that Adobe Premiere Pro, that Adobe Animate, any software you want to install, you have to acquire the skill. It is very simple. They are direct to actually make use of. So you have to understand that creating and using documents, spreadsheets, and presentation slide idea. So everybody out there right now have to understand how to use even PDF presentation, how to prepare a slide. This is my slide. I prepared this by myself. I decided to add animation. 2020, it is all about animation. So I decided to add animation because I want my viewer to be what to get to be looking at my object, and they should be what they should, it should be inviting them. Developing an understanding of social media platform and how learners can use them. Yes, social media is a place that is complicated right now. Please note, so far it is complicated does not mean that there are nothing for you to gain in that social media. I have been in the use of social media for a very long time, and I've traveled to more than 21 states just because of social media. I won't lie to you. If you understand how to use social media, not by snapping selfie, no. If you understand how to effectively use social media, you are going to find technology very simple to use in the classroom. Learning web navigation and search engine best practices. How do you Google search? Google search is very simple. There's a way I actually Google search. If you actually ask me to actually look for article about integrating technology into the classroom, there are about 10 ways I will search that. Even if I want to send it as an assignment to anybody out there, you won't see any of the documents online. So how do you do that? The first thing, let me teach you this. This is not what I'm going to teach you, but I'm going to teach you. You can start by writing, maybe you want to start about technology. I can write technology and write PTT. What do you mean of PTT? PowerPoint presentation. It's going to bring every PTT, PowerPoint presentation that is actually being saved on Google search engine. It's going to bring everything out immediately. Imagine searching and writing article. Imagine searching and writing bootcamp. Imagine searching and writing training. Imagine searching and writing. You can write PTT, PDF. So many statements you can write about article. So many things. School, practice, university. There are some statements you can write at the back. Research, hypothesis. So many things. And there's a site called Google Scholar. Google Scholar is another big space for you to get content. There are a lot of content there. And then you can actually make things happen by going to those places. So understanding the ways to actually search content online, you know, it's research skill. Research skill is also a very big skill. So you have to learn it. So it is part of the hardware maintenance. The next one, designing and maintaining website. Yes, everybody should know how to maintain and design website. And I'm going to teach you how to do that by the time I start my proper class. So incorporating educational software that supplement classroom instruction, Google Classroom, Edumodo, understanding how to use those tools. And then the last one, understanding, collecting and analyzing student achievement data. Yes, achievement data, that is their spreadsheet in terms of continuous assessment, reinforcement, and more. And then using video conferencing, Zoom, Google Meet, and other. So the next one, okay, I think I put number two above number one. I was like looking at it before. So the first one is working with software. Yes, you should be able to do some little troubleshooting. You should be able to do that for now. Caring and caring for equipment properly. Yes, don't allow dust to come in into your laptop. Make sure you clean your laptop. I am actually a victim of that. I don't know why I'm actually saying it. I don't clean my laptop every day, but I went to where I'm actually repairing the laptop some days back, and I observed that there are a lot of dust in the laptop, and that can actually damage the laptop. So that simply means that you have to care and properly maintain your devices. Developing an awareness of computer security and copyright law. Yes, you must not copy too much online. If you copy too much online, they are going to be after you, and it can actually affect you in the nearest future. Like a particular article said, that you can get a lot of content online, but you have to add your own personality inside that content. You have to add your own philosophy there. You have to add your own uniqueness there. That will make you to stand out. You can never be recognized for your similarity with those articles that you copy online. You can only be recognized for a difference. So by making sure that you add your own taste, your jara, your fisi inside those we serve as what has the major way to actually make sure that you are aware of copyright and security things over there. So the next one, technology integration is a dynamic process. Technology integration in education is more than the sum of hours spent on computer. Yes, if you spend 20 days on laptop thinking that you are typing this and that, it is not typing. It is a dynamic process coordinated by skilled teachers and supported by school leaders. School leaders have to actually help teachers out there. If you are a school leader and you are listening to me, you have to help teachers out there, because it is not just all about facing the laptop, pressing the phone alone. It is all about how effectively you use them to deploy learning in the classroom. So you have to help out also school leaders. So the next one, let's explore ways that we can actually integrate technology into the classroom. The first one is for us to understand all the elements out there. How many elements do we have? We have a lot of elements. We have Microsoft Teams, we have Edmodo, we have Google Classroom, even WhatsApp can be used as elements. It's just that there are some little things that you can find on it. Find in WhatsApp that are on Google Classroom and Edmodo. But we observe that in Africa, so many parents actually use WhatsApp. For now, you can even use WhatsApp for your live conferencing. I have a lot of video on YouTube. I'm going to send the link so that you can actually go and watch all those step by step how to use Edmodo, how to use Google Classroom, how to use WhatsApp for your effective teaching and learning process, how to use Google Team. I'm going to send all those pictures. This is an introduction class. So the next one, how to develop, you have to develop a website for your class. When we talk about making sure that we integrate technology into the classroom, we are also talking about bringing a website into the classroom. It is free. We have some websites that are free. Just go on google.com and press it there. Google Sites is free for everybody to create. When you create Google Site, it is free, and we find it very interesting to use Google Sites. You can store students, you can create each page, week one, week two, week three, and be dropping assignment there for children to even go and see online. So don't share the website with the public. Share the link alone with the parent and the student alone. So the student can be carried along about everything that is taking place in the classroom. And as much as possible, video content is very important. As you can see, my video is as clear as possible, and then I have a lot of nice background around me. I have about 3 studio, and then what actually prompts me to actually like video content for now? I observe that video content gets interest of learners than just creating than just copying a video online, or just doing a live Zoom conferencing. So video content will give you this is a pre-recorded video content. I'm not talking to you live, but I'm actually doing it in such a way that you are connecting with me live. So how do you create video content that will look as if you are connected to that child presently now? So video content are very important right now, and they are divided into various parts. We have animated video content. You can go and look for Plotagon on Play Store. It is not all phone that can download Plotagon, and you can also go and look for Render Forest. Render Forest is an application that you can use to create your animation, and lots of them. Those two, go and explore them. You will use them to create animation. We have Whiteboard. Whiteboard is on Render Forest. So, pre-recorded video, you need a tripod, you need a mic, you need a phone. It is not compulsory to use camera like mine. You can use your phone. I use my phone for most of the video that I've actually created in the past, and they have been awesome. So, your phone can do it, your laptop can do it, your camera can do it. Any tools you have right now can make things happen for you. So the next one, which is my final one. Finally, it is important to before I actually move to the final one, let me actually talk about your whiteboard. If you have a whiteboard in your school, in your classroom, There is this particular app that I'm going to send the link, as I said. It is called ClassroomScreen.com. ClassroomScreen.com will give you a dynamics whiteboard content in the classroom in such a way that teachers can come in and then you can do a lot on it. I know you are going to watch that video. You can also incorporate a game on that whiteboard also. Through the use of this classroom screen, you can also do that. And you can also show a lot of videos for the children to watch from YouTube, and then you can also create a kind of you can connect beyond your classroom through your whiteboard. I've actually connected through I've connected schools with so many schools outside of Nigeria just with the use of their whiteboard screen. You can connect with students all over the world. I call it Global Open Classroom, where we learn from other students in another environment. We tell them what we know, they tell us what they know. The other time we talk about water. They talk about water in their country, and we talk about water in our country. That was when we get to know that Finland did not actually have water in their country. And then it was awesome experience. Whereas we told them what we have, the kind of water we have. Some regions don't have water, good water. Some regions have good water. Some water causes cholera, this and that and more. And then they decided to tell us their own innovative way that they use in producing water. And it was nice. So Global Open Classroom is another best way to improve what to integrate technology into the classroom. And the next one, which is the final and conclusion, it is important to keep in mind that the intent behind integrating technology is simply existing resources and instructional content. Students are and always be there, will be the center focus of education. Yes, so technology needs to be effective and appropriately employed for their learning to thrive. It is not all about the technology itself, but it is what all about the students. Students are the major person in the classroom, and technology need to be effectively used appropriately in the classroom. So because it is technology, that does not mean that we should be mixing social media with technology in the classroom. We can use social media to get students at their attention, but make sure that there is security in the classroom. There's a way you can monitor the screen of students when they are pressing anything out of the content. You can do that. So try your best as much as possible. It is important for you to integrate technology, but you must make sure that it supplements the resources and instructional content. Or let me use the word, it enhances the instructional content and the resources in your classroom. I think I've actually taken my time to actually give you a very nice and direct view about how technology works in the classroom. And then it is very simple. There are ways to integrate it. I talk about Google Classroom. Google Classroom is a very big element. I use Google Classroom a lot. I use Edmodo a lot, MicroTeam a lot, WhatsApp a lot, video content, pre-recorded video content. There are lots. They are good for you. So, and I would like you to try your best as much as possible as I get to the end. So thank you very much for actually watching this video to the end. And I seriously appreciate. Thank you very much.